slices of pineapples, batteries, flashlights and cans of fish swam in puddles of beer on the floor, all dusted with a gooey layer of flour and cornmeal. The giant hypermarket Metro in Donetsk was flooded with looters Friday morning, grabbing whatever struck their fancy from its endless shelves. They seemed not to care that they were risking their lives. Just around the corner from the store, snipers opened fire at anyone who approached the nearby Donetsk airport. But as soon as the looters made it alive to the free consumer paradise, in a frenzy of greed or survival or both, they loaded up mountains of goods on their carts. On the floor of the wine department, drunken Valery moaned that his wife expected him to pick her up from work, but he wanted to stay and live in the free alcohol heaven. He insisted journalists not photograph his being drunk as a pig. Outside the shopping center, two more drunk looters described the violent scenes of shootings earlier this week between Ukrainian National Guard forces and rebels. On Thursday, the two men helped wounded local civilians to reach the hospital. The entire neighborhood was terrorized by stories about female snipers from the Baltic countries shooting men in the lower parts of their bodies. All that made the looting seem all right. And like Valery, Dmitry Yagudin realized that this could be his last chance to provide so plentifully for the six unemployed members of his family. He planned his looting carefully, eyeing the space available on his cart. He ignored bottles of expensive whiskey, blankets and hair dryers. In wartime, one needs more serious things, he explained, loading up blenders and juice makers. He passed right by the technology counters. No, computers are not for me, he said. I am not an insane looter. If not for Ukrainian helicopters and snipers in my neighborhood, I would never do this. Then he pushed his loot outside and up the street towards his house. Like a big wobbling shopping cart, the entire Donetsk region, it seemed, was slowly being pushed toward a very uncertain future where the fear of death, kidnapping, economic crises, disillusionment, unemployment and the sundry unknowable horrors of civil war all mingled.